John Kenneth Galbraith, who was one of our ambassadors and was a professor of economics in Harvard, wrote a book in 1956 called Affluent Society, where he said, advertisement is to tell, not to tell about the product to the consumer. It is to entice the consumer to buy the product when he doesn't need it. You go to a mall, you see three shirts for one shirt's cost. Now that's advertisement. Ek sari le lijiyega, do free free. There's nothing free. One sari, he have paid all the three saris cost. So this is all enticement. So don't believe any drug or any food that is advertised is poison. So food that is your ancestors eat. What is the best food for people? Lot some people say, I'll have this diet, that diet, what's that called? Mediterranean diet. Mediterranean diet is meant for Mediterranean people, not for you. Your diet is what your ancestors have been eating. You know, if your father has been eating something, your grandfather has been eating something, that's your best diet. Don't change it. If I go to Rajasthan now, what will you get there? Chapati and suki sabji, rasar sabji, that's all. But I have a South Indian meal. Actually, South Indian meal is very good. For diabetic patients now, in America, they give South Indian rice diet. And here, we doctors tell you, don't see rice, you will die of diabetes. Actually, rice, brown rice, has a medicine for diabetes called metronidazole. It's come from the thawdu, the cover, the bran. But white rice, of course, is poison because it's only sugar, nothing else is there. Brown rice is so good that it's a treatment for diabetes. But nobody bothers. Now, recent studies have shown that your own environment is your best thing. And lot of people say, oh, we eat like hunter-gatherers diet. Hunter-gatherers is to work very hard. Their diet can't be suitable for you. But your diet must be something different. Your father might have been eating a big meal, but he was working very hard. You don't work. See, young ladies now, it's shoulder pain, frozen shoulder. I still see, I can visualize my mother. She used to grind for idli. Today who grinds? You press a button, chirr, it goes. That is the cause of your illness, not the diet. So the idli is the same, whether it is made by chirr or this. But with this, she was healthy because she was grinding it. And you take water from the well, it's very good for health. Today, no, you just turn the tap, water comes. So this is where we have become now almost immobile. That is why we require exercise. But we doctors sometimes blindly tell. I saw a young doctor the other day telling a farmer, you must walk for 1 mile. I told him, young man, this man will walk all that you have walked all your life in one day. Have you ever walked in a wet field? It's so difficult to walk in a wet field. You put your leg there, it goes deep in, gets stuck there. To pull it out, you require energy. This boy doesn't know that because he has solely studied at the medical college, read the books, and he's reading the books onto the patient. That's our problem. We read the books onto the patient. And patient asks a question, you say, don't ask questions. It's silly. That man, gentleman who was with me was telling, he has a cousin who is a doctor, I believe. When he asks questions to her, she says, don't come to see me anymore. Because your silly questions I can't answer. But his questions are so profound that no question is silly. Answers can be silly. Questions can be very profound. And he had a very good question actually. I would love to answer that question. Because he was asking me, doesn't your body get used to a higher level of sugar? It does. I'll give you an example. Now, I'll take this front row. And if I have the blood sugar level, I'll check everybody's blood sugar. How many? If you are 25 people, 25 readings will come in that. No two readings will be alike. Now what do? We take the average of that and call it as normal. This is the biggest curse on mankind. That's only an average, statistical average, can't be normal. If you really go for a checkup, now for example, all of your blood sugars are checked, there'll be different readings. If I take an average and see, none of you is normal. None of you, remember, mark my words, none of you is normal. You're either high or low. So both ways you're a patient. So you go for a checkup as a human being, you come out as a patient. because of our statistical methods. This is okay for one blood sugar. But if you take about 200 parameters, that's what they do in corporate hospitals. But corporate hospitals are there to make money. So you go there, they'll take your blood and then give a big thick report, you know, this thick report. And then charge you maybe about 20,000, 30,000, 40,000 rupees. But if you look at this report very carefully, many places it will be written in thick letters, abnormal, 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 abnormal. Then you come to the, a lot of people come to me and say, sir, my uric acid is slightly on the higher side. I said, so what? What's your problem? I have no problem. I said, then it's the doctor's problem. Why are you worried about it? It's very interesting. The other day I was lecturing in an NITK, you know, National Institute of Technology. And I told the boys, they were doing biomedical engineering. I told them, have you got a weighing machine? They got a weighing machine. I said, now keep it here. Now 10 of you come, weigh yourself and write down the weights. And then say, this is the weight. What's the average weight? So they calculated. I said, any one of you has the average weight? No. Then you are abnormal. You know, this is very difficult. What is the normal Indian height of a male? We take 1,000 people. Take the average, huh? It's about 5.4 plus minus 2. So, let's say 5.6. How many of us are 5.6 exactly? Amitabh Bachchan goes for a checkup. 6.2. So the treatment is cut his leg, make him 5.6. Jaya Bachchan goes for a checkup, 4.6. Transplant that leg to her and make her also normal. This is the medicine we practice. Don't practice that medicine. Your medicine is, are you feeling happy? Are you healthy? Do you love others? Do you work hard? You are fine. That's so beautifully put by Ayurveda. Samadhatu samagnischa samadosha malakriya prasanna atma indriya manasvastha ityabhidhiyate. You get up in the morning and say, did I sleep well? Do I eat well? Did I shit well? Did I piss well? And am I happy? Do I hate anybody? Nobody. Then you are healthy. Nothing to worry. But if you hate somebody, you are not healthy. You are very dangerously ill. And you and death are very, very close to each other. So don't hate people. Love others. Do you know why? You are not a single individual. That's why you are not I. You are a cell when you are made in a mother's womb, called a zygote. One cell, one single cell, human cell. But that cell was like you. It could think, it could eat, it could piss, it could shit, it could do everything. That cell has divided over a period of time into 122 trillion cells, each of them individually capable of being human beings. So I call them a colony. So each one of us is a colony of 120 human beings, loving each other so much. Today you have a biophoton camera. If I photograph you, I can see your cells jumping with happiness. And when they are jumping with happiness, you are healthy. But the minute you start hating someone else, supposing I sit with Justice Kothari, and then I am jealous of his position, etc. Then I say, when will I be just like Kothari? I must pull him down and put him down, somehow or other. The minute the thought goes in, your cells feel bad. Because sitting here, my cells have started loving Kothari cells. They love each other so much. But if the owner hates the other person, the cells say, why is he doing that? Is he very foolish? I love Kothari Sahab. Why is he hating Kothari Sahab? Still I go on hating Kothari Sahab further. A stage will come, my own cells hate my own cells. That's called autoimmune disease. Have you heard of that? There's no treatment for this autoimmune disease. You go to a doctor, he'll give you a steroid. That's not a treatment, that's making you worse. But autoimmune disease can be corrected by the mind. You just have to tell your mind to be happy and not hate nobody. There is a nice book for all of you to read. Please read that. It's a small book. It's called Anatomy of an Illness. What's the book's name? Anatomy of an Illness. It's written by an American journalist. Very good English. His name is Norman Cousins. Norman was a great journalist. So he was covering Khrushchev Kennedy meeting in the Moscow airport where a jet was turning. So the jet, the hot jet fuel, jet air hit this man at the temperature of minus 30 degrees. So from then on, he started having stiffness in the muscles and joints. And to cut the long story short, he had a disease called ankylosing spondylitis, for which our textbooks have no treatment at all. And this man is supposed to die in another 6 months' time. He was admitted to Harvard Hospital because he was a very rich man, big man in America, big name, Norman Cousins. So the doctors told him, you have only 6 months to live. I don't know how the doctors have become astrologers these days. We are predicting the unpredictable future of patients. Then anyway, they told him in 6 months, just be here. So he was there, not able to move even a finger. One day some of his friends came there, and he old friends, old time's sake, they were all joking around, and suddenly everybody laughed. And Norman also laughed for the first time. He laughed so loudly that he saw his fingers moving. Then his friends collected a lot of these Charlie Chaplin movies those days. You know, there were no television, so they brought this 16 millimeter gudu 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 run. In the olden days, have you gone to a cinema theater? After 1 hour it will stop. Next reel will come. It went on, he laughed, 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 laughed. 3 months later he was perfectly normal, went home, lived for another 50 years and died at the old age. And then he wrote, it's all in your mind. Happiness is the reason why you feel so happy, so healthy and so nice. Diseases are accidents. Even if you are healthy, you can still get a disease. But if you follow the health rules, diseases are less. Like if you follow the traffic rules, accidents are less. But even with the best traffic rules, accidents do occur. So one can't say, I will not get a disease, I will be very healthy. No, no, you can't say that. You can say, I will live a healthy life and be happy. That's in your control.